Welcome to part 3 of our tutorial on painting Nagash. Now in this part I'm going to be focusing mainly on the body, but there's also some sub-assemblies I'll be doing too that are tied to it, things like the head and the shoulder. Also, I'm going to be showing you some techniques that you need to repeat on the robes. This will be for things like the belts and skulls and things, and I'll let you know as we encounter them. Now by the end of this video, Nagash will almost be finished. In fact, all we'll have to do is a few final details and the last assembly as well. So, let's get cracking! The first part I'm going to be painting on the body will be the sleeves, and these are going to be done in the same way as I did the robes. Now you might be wondering why I didn't just do them at the same time when I was painting the robes, and that's because on larger models like this, it's often a good idea to focus on one part at a time, especially quite a complex part like on the robes. But as I say, it's going to be done in the same way. So I'm going to be starting out with a base coat of Celestial Grey, and then I'm going to be doing a base coat of Incubi Darkness and getting that zigzag pattern between the two of them. Then I'm going to go over the Celestial Grey with Nylac Oxide, and then I'll start blending these colours together by doing a mix of Collier Green Shade and Lamia Medium. Once that's done, I'm going to darken down the top of the sleeves with another mix, this time of Norn Oil and Lamia Medium. So to start out, I'm going to be using my large brush, and I'm going to be applying this colour towards the bottom. So it's Celestial Grey, just thin down just a little bit, and just make sure you bring your bristles to a nice point on your palette. So I'm going to be painting this on the bottom half of the sleeves, and I'm going to be making that zigzag pattern about halfway up, so I think just about to there should be just fine. Now as before, you'll probably need to apply more than one coat of this to get a solid colour, but that's absolutely fine. Just let the first layer dry, then apply a second. Then switch to a standard brush and start painting Incubi Darkness downwards from the top. Once again, just bringing it to a point as you start transitioning between the two colours. Once the Incubi Darkness is dry, I'm just going to start applying Nylac Oxide over the Celestial Grey. And I'm going to be covering the whole area down here, and also I'm going to allow it to start to overlap the Incubi Darkness just a bit to help start out with the blend. Now I'm going to start applying the shade to make my blend, and I've got my mix here of one part Collier Green Shade to three parts Lamia Medium. And because there's no spirits in the sleeves, I'm going to start by doing the entire thing. But what you need to do is apply a coat like this, let it dry completely, then apply a second one, again narrowing slightly more towards the actual transition. So I'll be going up to about that point that time. Now I'm expecting this is going to take, well, at least 8 coats. So it might be more for you, it might be less, but you just need to keep on going until you get to a result that you're happy with. So now I've got to a result I'm happy with, and it took 8 or 9 coats, but there's not much more left to do to finish the blend. It's just the black towards the top now. So I've got my mix once again of Norn Oil and Lamia Medium, about 1 to 3, and I'm just going to be painting this towards the top here. So not very far down this time, because a shoulder pad's going to be covering most of this, so I'm not even going to be going to pure black really. It's going to be doing along there and just up here as well. And I think I'll be doing 3 or 4 coats or so. Now if you want a bit more guidance on doing this, of course, then just check out part 2 of this guide. I've added 4 layers in the end, and now I've got to a point that I'm happy with. So I can move on now to adding the highlights to the sleeves. Now for this, I'm going to be doing the same technique that I did in the robes, so I'm going to be edge highlighting them. Now this time you don't need to go all the way up to White Scar. Instead, I'm just going to do Cobalt Green first, then Cyberite Green after that. And both of these colours I'll be applying using my fine detail brush. So starting with a Cobalt Green, you just need to get your paint ready. As before, thinning it down with a little bit of water so that it flows easily, and making sure that you bring your brush to a nice fine tip. And you're looking to paint this along all the edges on the sleeves. So on this one, for example, just round here, you can use the edge of your brush just to bring that green line down, and you just go down until it starts to disappear into the green you've got already. Now there are lots of little holes to do as well, and also the wrinkles running down the sleeves. And for these, you just need to paint a thin line just running around the most raised surface of them, again, until you disappear into that green down towards the bottom. And then with Cyberite Green, do some more edge highlights, this time focusing on the edges of the sleeves and also the little holes. You don't need to worry about the creases this time. And And with that last highlight done, the sleeves are now finished, and I can move on to base coating a whole bunch of different areas on the gash now. And all these areas use Rakarth flesh, which is why I'm going to do them all at the same time. Now these areas are the lighter bone areas, so things like the trim on his armour and his face as well. There's the darker bone areas, like on his shoulder, and also there's his skin as well. And I'm going to be using both a large brush and a standard brush for doing this, and I'm going to switch back and forth between them as I need to. So get your paint ready on your palette, and you're just looking at getting a nice even base coat of this. So you might find you need to do two layers. If you do, that's fine. Just let one coat dry, then apply a second coat. Now there are a lot of areas to do like this, so I do advise that you use your box art for some reference to guide you through it. Make sure you get them all, but also there's some areas that you're going to be painting later on, things like the purple armour plating around here. You can be messy on those parts because we're going to be painting over that anyway later on, so just work around the whole model, getting all these parts, but be careful when you're getting close to the sleeves so that you don't get any paint on those. So there we go, now I've finished putting the Rakarth flesh as a base coat over all these different assemblies, and as you can see I've been quite messy with it, but that's fine because now we've got a really good foundation to work from for the following details. I've also done the base coat on some areas on the robe sub-assembly as well, so on the sword scabbard here, the skulls on his belt, and also that little tab at the top there, which is actually part of his hip, so don't forget about that. Now, the first of these areas I'm going to focus on painting is the darker bone, which is something I've not really done before, so I'll go into detail on it. Now, for this, the first colour you need is Agarak's Earthshade, and I'm going to be painting this onto his shoulder for a clear example of how to do it, but there are a couple of other details on the model as well, so check your box art to find out which parts those are. Now, for this part, I'm going to be using my large brush, but I've also got a standard brush for the smaller areas. And for this first stage, all you're looking to do is apply a good amount of Agarak's Earthshade over the whole area that you want to be this darker colour. Now try and get this as smooth as you can. The smoother it dries, the better the final result will be. And of course, make sure you give this plenty of time to dry. About 10 minutes should be fine. When the first coat is completely dry, apply a second coat, but apply it thinly. So don't put on too much at once, just keep it thin like I'm doing here. And focus it as best you can around the edges and the recesses. Now the second coat's dry, I just want to quickly show you something before I start moving on to the highlighting stages. And this is especially useful if the shades happen to dry blotchy, it's a great way to rectify it. What you need is Baneblade Brown and Lamium Medium, and I'm going to be making a mix once again, this time about 1:1, and I'm using a detail brush for this. So there's my paint, get a good amount of medium, and just start mixing that together. So I've got a very smooth colour here, you see, and you don't need very much on your brush, so use your palette to get rid of the excess. Now this is great for painting on the larger, smoother areas, such as the skull's forehead. This can really smoothen out the colour. So you see, if I put this on evenly, it's very subtle, but you can use it to get a nice, smooth highlight, really, on large open areas like this. So it's great if you happen to have any blotches on here for getting rid of those. And also, on the bottom here on the jaw, shade tends to collect very easily around the bottom teeth. So you can use this just to neaten that area up and redefine the bottom jaw. And there you see, using this technique, it's very easy to get a nice variation on a colour like this. And then when you're ready, we can start adding the highlights to this colour. And I'm going to be using Rakarth Flesh for the first colour for this, so I'm actually going back to my original base colour. But because this is so dark now, this will stand out nicely as a highlight. I'm going to be applying this using my fine detail brush, and I'm going to be doing this as an edge highlight. So, as before, you just need to get that good tip in your brush and thin your paint down a little bit. And what you're looking to do is paint this on all the edges. So on the skull, that means you're looking at things like around the eye socket, for example. All the edges just around here, and you see this colour now very starkly stands out. But doing this really brings out all that shape and definition of the skull. Now you need to do this around all of here, so you're looking at things like the brow, around the nose, the teeth, and so on. But when you get to doing areas like the sword scabbard on the tip of it, you're looking to do an edge highlight just like you were doing with the robes earlier. So thin lines around all the sharpest edges. Now I've finished doing the edge highlight on here, you can see it's made a really big difference, and in fact, this colour is nearly done. All that's left to do is to add another highlight, this time using Pallid Witch Flesh. And I'm still going to be applying this using the fine detailed brush, because it is really another edge highlight. So, thin your paint down and get it ready. And this I'm looking to paint only on the most raised surfaces. This is just to really bring them out. So on the skull, I'm looking at doing things like round the side here, just a small amount, just on that sharp bit there, just to really make it pop out. So I'm looking at areas like around here, for example, on the teeth as well, on the bottom of the chin, On the brow, you just need a small part, just in the very middle there. But you won't need very much. You can see it really just finishes this off. So there we go. Now the darker area of bone is done. And also you can see how it's come out on the sword scabbard there. And with that finished, now we can move on to painting the lighter areas of bone. There's quite a few of these, and I'm going to be doing them in a similar way to how I normally do them. Only this time I'm going to start out with a shabty bone first of all. Then I'll shade over these using Agrax Earth Shade, and then layer again using a shabty bone. After that we'll start the highlights, starting with Screaming Skull first of all, then White Scar, then after that I'm going to do the darker brown areas on the tips of the spines using Agrax Earth Shade and some Labian Medium as well. So starting with your shabty bone, I'm going to be applying this using, well, my same two brushes. I've got the large brush and the standard brush for this kind of thing. And I just need to get the paint ready on the palette first of all. And I'm looking to apply this as a layer completely over the areas I want to be this light colour. So, on his head, for example, I'm going to be painting this all over these lighter areas. So you want a good even coat. Keep the paint thin though, so it doesn't start clogging up any detail. Once you've got an even coat of a shabty bone, the next stage is to apply Agrax Earthshade over all these areas. Now as you're applying this, don't put it on too thickly. Keep it moving like I'm doing here so that it settles in the recesses, but doesn't blob up too much on the raised areas. Now I'm using a large brush for this, and I've also got a standard brush for smaller areas. That's because a wash brush would collect a bit too much shade, and I'd risk losing control of it then. You don't want to get this on any areas that you've already painted, like the sleeves. Once the shade is completely dry, the next stage is to layer again using a shabty bone. Now I'm using smaller brushes for doing this. I've got a detail brush here, and I'm also going to be using a standard brush for larger areas. But what you're looking to do is to paint this as smoothly as you can over all these bone details whilst leaving the darker colour showing in the recesses. Like on this chin here, you see, it's brightening it right up there. So you need to go around all these areas now doing this, and it will take a while, but it's worth it because, well, as you can see, it looks really good, especially around the areas where the darker colours are, where it will provide a really strong contrast. Once you finish that layer, we can start doing the highlights, and the first of these is Screaming Skull, which I'm going to apply using my fine detail brush, and this is going to be an edge highlight, so I'm going to be painting thin lines just around all the edges of detail, just like on his face down there. Now when you come to more ridged parts like spines and things, what you can do is just paint a small amount of this colour just on the top of these ridges, just like I'm doing down here, and then on the most prominent details as well, like on the side, I just need to put a little bit just down there. And you see, doing this just really helps define all those shapes and all that detail. I just want to point out that when you get to areas like this, it can look a bit intimidating, all these different ridges on the spines, but actually this can be quite quick. When I was doing my layering, you can see how on each segment, I layered on either side, but I didn't do the middle, I left that the darker colour. So I'm just going to go as far as that for those different segments, and when I come to highlighting with Screaming Skull now, I'm just going to concentrate on these ridges either side. So just need to put a little bit of the lighter colour running along there, on these little bits as well. So you see, actually doing these segments is pretty quick now. The final step for highlighting the bone is to add just a bit of white scar, but this time you only want to focus this on the most sharpest and most prominent details. So for here, I'm just doing the bottom of his chin, for example, and that's the only part of that I need to highlight, just to really brighten the tip up. Now, I'm going to be doing the same on all the tips of spines as well, like down the top here. So again, not very much. But also, it's a good idea to do some on the face, because the face is the focal point of the miniature. So around here, I'll be looking at doing things like the teeth and also the cheekbones just around there, just to finish them off. So what you need to do now is work around the miniature, just doing this again on only the most sharpest, most prominent details, and then the bone is almost finished. And there we go, now the bone is pretty much done. In fact, there's only one more little thing to do, and that is just on the spines that go on his back. These darken down towards the tips, so to do this, I'm going to be making a mix of Agrax Earthshade and Labian Medium. So, like with all the blends we've been doing before, I'm going for the same mix of one part Agrax Earthshade here to three parts Medium. So, that's one, two, and three. And I'm using my standard brush to apply this. So, once you've got your colour ready, as before, make sure you don't have too much on your brush. And you're looking at painting this just towards the tips of these spines. So I'm going to be going up to about there for the first coat. And just like before with those blends, the first coat's subtle, but what I'm going to do is let this dry completely, then apply another one a little bit further up, another one just a bit further to the tip, I think this is going to take about four coats or so to get to the result that I want, but it's just a matter of applying more layers like this, always keeping it thin, till you get to a point that you're happy with. And with that, the bone is now complete. And the next thing I'm going to focus on is going to be Nagash's flesh. Now this we already base coated earlier with Rakarth flesh. So the first stage I'm going to do now is to shade the whole thing with Agrax Earthshade. After that, I'm going to neaten up again with Rakarth flesh, but then I'm going to shade it using a mix of Athonian Camo Shade and Lamium Medium, a one-to-one mix. After that, I'm going to highlight using Rakarth flesh, and then I'll be focusing just on the stitching down the middle of his stomach. And for this, I'm first going to do a one-to-one mix of Druki Violet and Lamium Medium, and then I'm going to highlight it using Pallid Witch flesh. So for the first step, I'm going to be applying this using a large brush. I'm going to get my Agrax Earthshade ready, and this is just going to be a good even coat across all of his skin. So on his belly here, I'm just looking at painting an even coat like this, not too thickly so it doesn't start running, just let it settle in those recesses, just like this. Now don't forget as well, there's a little part on the robes that are the same for part of his hip bone, don't forget to do that too. Next, apply a layer of Rakarth flesh using a standard brush over all the skin, leaving the darkest colour still showing in the deepest recesses. And of course, don't forget to do the little part on the robe assembly as well. Once the layer of Rakarth flesh is done, the next step is to apply a mix of Athonian Camo Shade and Lamium Medium, and this is a one-to-one mix. Now doing this is going to give the flesh a nice greenish tint, and also it's really going to start to separate it from the rest of the bone. Once that shade's completely dry, go back to Rakarth flesh and use your detail brush to apply it as a highlight this time. So I'm looking to apply thin lines following all the most raised areas of detail. So like around here, for example, I'm going to be just running along the ribs, but I'll also be doing some along the base of the rib cage there. When you get down to the sinew down here, you just need to follow it down. Once again, just applying thin lines just to highlight these areas. And now the majority of the flesh is done. All you need to do now is just get these stitches done. And for this, the first step is to mix up Druki Violet and Lamium Medium to a one-to-one mix again, and just paint it down amongst the stitches here. Keep it localized around them, and this will give you that nice bruising effect. And then the final step is to use some Pallid Witch flesh to highlight the stitches. So I'm using my fine detail brush for this, and you just need to paint thin lines just running along each stitch, just like that. And once you've done this, the flesh will be complete. So with the stitching done, the flesh is now complete. And now I'm going to move on to start painting the armour plates. Now I'm going to begin with a base coat of Nagash Nightshade for this, and I'm going to be applying it using both a standard brush and a fine detail brush as well. Now this colour is quite a thin colour, so you are going to need to apply more than one coat of it. So when you're ready, you just need to start putting this on as even a base coat as you can get. But as you can see here, you'll still be able to see some of the colours through it, just around there where it's getting a bit thinner. So be as neat as you can whilst you're doing this and really take your time for it, because it's important that you don't get it on the trim. If you do, just neaten up as you go. And the reason I've got that fine detail brush is for when I'm getting to areas like down here, I can just switch to the smaller brush and use that to fill that in. Now there are quite a lot of places to do like this for the armour, so reference your box artwork and use that to guide you through the process. Now I've finished my base coat of Nagash Knight, I can move on to start highlighting this. Now, the technique here is going to be edge highlighting, so similar to when we were doing the cloak, but because the detail's not so pronounced, you do need a steady hand to do this. I'm going to be using a fine detail brush, and the colour is rust grey. So get your paint ready first of all, and I'm definitely going to be thinning down with a little bit of water at this stage, so that the paint will flow smoothly, and get that nice tip on your brush. And you're looking now to paint thin lines following the edge of every one of these armour panels. So you do need to take your time with this, and be patient with it, because it will take a little while to do, but once you've finished, your model's going to look amazing. The results here are absolutely worth it. So it's taken a bit of time, but you can see that now I've finished the edge highlights, it's really helped define all the different panels on the armour. Now the next stage is to do another edge highlight, but this time it's going to be a little bit more focused. So I'm going to be using Fenrisian Grey this time, and I'm still using my fine detail brush, and the application method is very much the same, only this time I'm going to be just more focused about where I put it. So once you've got your paint ready, you're looking for the most sharpest angles on the armour. So on the chest plate, for example, I'm looking at this kind of area here where that angle is. So you just need to do another edge highlight just down here but just around this kind of area. So not the whole thing, just about half a centimetre or so either side on an area like this. I've finished the second highlight now, but you can see that the colours are a little bit stark. So what I'm going to do is apply a shade over these panels to really subdue these colours and bring them together as well. Now the colour I'm going to use is Druky Violet. I'm going to be applying this using a detailed brush, and it's very important during this stage that you be as neat as you can. So what I'm going to do is get the paint ready and make sure that I don't have a lot of it on the brush. And what you need to do is pick a panel and start painting it with this shade smoothly across the whole area, being as neat as you can when you get close to those edges there so that you don't get any onto the trim. Now what I recommend you do with this stage is paint one panel at a time, let it dry completely, then move on to the next one, because it's very frustrating, believe me, when you accidentally smudge some of this. So let each one dry before you move on. So now the shade is dry, you can see it's really brought all those colours together, but the highlights are still clearly visible, so we've got nice sharp serrated armour plates. So now there's just one more thing to do on the armour, and that's to paint the rivets, and for this all you need is runefang steel and a fine detailed brush. So get your paint ready and make sure you don't have too much on the brush, because all you're doing here is just painting little dots really on the raised surface. So just make sure you haven't got too much paint there on your brush. And keep a steady hand as you possibly can during this process, because all you're looking to do is paint dots just like this. So you just need to work around the armour now, doing this on each panel where the rivets appear. And now that the rivets are done, the armour is complete, and I can move on to the final thing that I'm going to show you how to paint in this video, and that's to paint the lighter purple that appears on the ribbons that come from his head, and also the sword grip as well. Now for this you're going to need four colours. We're going to start with a base coat of Demonette Hide, then I'm going to shade the whole area using Druky Violet. After that I'm going to highlight using Warp Fiend Grey, and then finally do a very fine highlight with a Shabti Bone. So for the base coat I'm going to be applying it using a standard brush, so this is Demonette Hide. Just need to get it ready on your palette, and for this you're just looking for as even a base coat as you can get. So on the head here I'm just going to be painting it as neatly as possible onto these areas. Once the base coat's done, apply a shade of Druky Violet over these areas, and don't forget the sword grip as well, but make sure when you're putting this on you don't put on too much so that you can keep in control of it. When the shade's completely dry, the next thing to do is apply an edge highlight with Warp Fiend Grey, and I'm using a fine detail brush to do this. Now it is a little bit trickier when you're painting it on the sword grip, so just make sure that you keep a steady hand as you're doing that part. And the final stage is just to add a small edge highlight of a Shabti Bone just at the very tips of the ribbons down here. Not very much, and you don't need to do this on the sword, but as you can see this just finishes these parts off. And there we go, we're now at the end of part 3, and as you can see we've really come along leaps and bounds in this part because all the main parts of Nagash are now finished. Now when you're doing this part, there are a couple of parts on Nagash that will take you a while to paint, things like the bone trim and the purple armour especially, and when you're doing these parts, just be patient and take your time, because this model is an absolute centrepiece to any collection, so the more time you take on it, the better it will look. Now also, and I often say it, but just be as neat as you can during these parts, because the neater you are, the better the final result will be. And also, I was using Lamia Medium quite a lot in this part, and that's because it allowed me to dilute my paints without changing their properties, and doing this can get you some really nice effects, not just for something like Nagash, but loads of other models too. Now we're going to move on to part 4, and in part 4 I'll be doing all the remaining details, so things like the books and the sword blade and that kind of thing. And also I'm going to show you how to do the final assembly, and that's the part I'm looking forward to the most, so I'll see you in part 4.